A woman in the UK had a startling surprise just moments before giving birth, and it wasn't that she was having twins. It turns out her doting boyfriend wasn't who she thought he was.
The moment your child is born, you're delivered a precious gift. That's the picture-perfect memory for 37-year-old Gemma Powell. But right before her child entered the world, hers was rocked and robbed. Her boyfriend, also the baby's father, had a shocking slip of the tongue. The doctor asked the doting dad his name, and the father, who went by Alex, replied and said Douglas. Gemma soon found out that not only was her boyfriend lying about his identity, he was leading a double life and was already married the entire time that he and Gemma were together. Could your partner already be partnered with a secret life? And how would you know if they're a sociopath?
I'd rather be with a robot than a sociopath.
That is very true.
Yeah, now that puts that into context.
Imagine that scenario. You find out as you're giving birth that the dude you're with is married to someone else?
But this is my question. Like, every case is going to be different, so I'm not, like, placing blame on this woman at all, because it's definitely not her fault. But in general, so generally speaking, if you're with someone for that long, do you normally have some clues, or do they just, like, surprise, yeah, I'm a sociopath?
So sociopath and psychopath, we use colloquially in our psychology world, it's called antisocial personality disorder. So we recognize that it's usually kind of like more of a lifelong personality-based thing. There's some genetic variant of it, though. So there was this neuroscientist at UC Irvine, his name is Jim Fallon, and he scanned hundreds of brains of people he thought were psychopathic, and this is a startling discovery he made. Not only is about 1 to 3 out of 100 having sort of this genetic variant, which is called an MAOA, he had it. Then he started to scan his family, and they all had it. So there is something about it being genetically passed down. It's a variant that is responsible for processing and breaking down the neurotransmitters that are associated with mood, like serotonin and dopamine. So there is a genetic process, but it doesn't mean that everybody expresses those things. So once you have sort of this genetic predisposition, you may express it in the form of having low empathy, looking at other human beings like a means to an end, they're just for you to reach your goals, and just in general, a very superficial
having no filter, no shame, no guilt.
Very superficial levels of emotional connectivity. So their relationship's all very at the surface, and they're very good charmers, and that's why people like them. They see what you need, and then they'll go for it. So if they see that you're somebody who might have a little low self-esteem, maybe a little insecure, they'll just ravish you, give you all those compliments you've been craving, and make you feel really connected to them that way. And that might have been what happened.
Question for you before we go to break. If you encounter someone like this and you're in this deep, you're having a child, and you know this is the way someone is, a true personality disorder, very different than a psychiatric condition that maybe you could formally treat, do you just say no, I'm pushing you out of my life because you have this issue that I can't have in my world, even though you're the father of my child.
Very difficult to treat, if not impossible.
Very difficult to treat because they don't see themselves as the problem. That's part of the issue. And so, yes, I believe if you finally notice you are with an antisocial personality disorder person, you just need to cut those ties immediately and just really raise your child right without those sort of social proclivities.
All right, man, don't freak everybody out there.
Can you just give like a red flag? Just one big red flag.
One big red flag.
Please.
They attach to you super quickly. So after one date, I miss you. You are the love of my life, and I want to marry you. You know,
that's
I think that just seems too
robot.
Fast. No. Well, but see, that's a robot.
Too fast.
A robot can't have antisocial personality disorder.
Well, just be aware that these people with bad intentions are out there.